What does tension, what does stress have to do with racial stereotypes? Well, I'm going to be talking to you about that in today's video. Hi there, my name is Morgan Brisden, and I'm the creator of Center Studio, where I teach people skills to feel more comfortable more often. Now, recently, I've been teaching a lot of workshops, a lot of classes, and there's sort of a theme that keeps coming up among some of my students. And so I thought I would share this video with you in case it resonated, in case any of what I'm saying is going to strike something close to home for you and might be worth exploring. So the first example I wanted to tell you about was from a young African-American man that I was working with here, and he had told me when I had asked him about relaxing his face and his face muscles, he said, you know, I had sort of this realization recently, and he said that I specifically, at some point in my life, started kind of carrying a lot of tension in my forehead by raising my eyebrows up. He said, I opened my eyes a little bit larger, and I sort of put my cheekbones up because I want to have a smile on my face. He said, I'm afraid that if I relax my face muscles, that then I'm gonna come across as an angry black man. So that's what this individual student said to me. And similarly, I recently got a note from a young woman who said, you know, I realized when you were talking us through constructive rest, she said, I'm Korean American, and I never realized that I'm holding all this tension in my eyes because of this long time habit of trying to keep my eyes really big and open. She said, you know, growing up, Asians are always considered to have small eyes, and I didn't want to be associated with that. I didn't want people to think that about me. And I think this is really interesting because the relationship between our habits and our beliefs are really intertwined, and sometimes we don't always recognize it. We don't always relate the two together. So what I'm going to suggest to you all is for you to consider, where am I experiencing physical tension, physical strain in my body? And especially if it's repetitive, if it's often and it's, let's even call it chronic, is there any relationship to any beliefs that you have? And they could be stereotypes of any kind, really. They could even be gender stereotypes that you have, disability stereotypes. You know, maybe you're a woman who feels that you have to pull in your stomach because you have to appear like you don't have a big belly. Or maybe you're somebody who has scoliosis, and your spine, when you're relaxed, is actually very much, you know, to the side and a little bit distorted. So you feel like you have to physically pick yourself up in order to appear to others like you are upright and have good posture. But in reality, that's actually causing tension in another place in your body, right? So I'm just gonna put that out there for you all in case you've never even considered the fact that they could be related. In case you're somebody who's gone about living your life, holding yourself in certain ways because of beliefs you have. And again, maybe it's not something you can abandon completely, like tomorrow you're gonna wake up and stop trying to fix your scoliosis or not have sort of this bright smile on your face. But maybe, just maybe, you could give yourself more opportunities to relax, right? Maybe you go into your car and you're driving on your own and you can let that belly go, or let the sort of upright desire go, or let your face relax. And just find moments in your life where you can give your body more opportunities to rest. And hopefully you'll see some direct response to that as far as how you feel. Maybe you'll experience more relaxation and ease and freedom in your body because you've been able to let that go more often. All right, friends, if you haven't already, I'd love if you would subscribe to my channel. You can do so by hitting the button below. Okay, until next time, friends, take care. Ciao.